Hi friends. Today I am going to take up trigonometric functions of compound angles. Now, what do we mean by compound angle? First, let us see what is a compound angle. Now, sometimes, for example, let us say we have, they say, find sine of 105 degrees without using table or calculator. We are asked to find sine of 105 degrees without using either tables or calculator. Now, this angle is not a well-known angle. And this problem cannot be solved even with the help of allied angles, because if you take allied angles, this is between 90 and 180. Now, it can be written as either sine of 90 plus 15 or sine of 180 minus 75. Now, this 15 degree and 75 degree, they are also not well-known angles. So, even with the help of allied angles, we cannot solve this. Now, what I can do here is, I can write it as sine of 60 degree plus 45 degree. 60 plus 45 is 105. Now, this is called as a compound angle. A compound angle is sum of two angles or difference between two angles is called as the compound angle. Now, for this, there is a formula. The formula is sine of A plus B. We have to use this formula. Sine of A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. So, using this formula, I have to do this. So, this will be equal to sine A means sine 60 into cos B. B is 45 degree. So, cos 45 degree plus cos A cos 60 degree into sine B, sine of 45 degree. You know, sine 60 is root 3 by 2 into this is 1 by root 2 plus cos 60 is again root 3 by 2 and sine 45 is 1 by root 2. So, this will be root 3 by 2 root 2 plus root 3 by 2 root 2, or it will be 2 times root 3 by 2 root 2. This 2 gets cancelled, so the answer, final answer is root 3 by root 2. Now, this is how it can be done. To give you one more example, let us say, we get a problem like this. Find the value of cos 15 degree without using table or calculator. Again, this can be written as either cos of 60 degree minus 45 degree. 60 minus 45 is 15, or it can be written as 45 minus 30 also. You get the same answer. Final answer will be same whatever you take. Now here, I will have to use this relationship, cos of A minus B. Cos of A minus B. Here it is the difference between two angles. So A minus B. Cos of A minus B. Now the expansion of this is cos A cos B minus, plus sin A sin B. So it will be cos A cos B, cos 60 cos 45, cos 60 degree cos 45 degree, plus sin A sin 60 degree into sin 45 degree. Like this I will have to do. Cos 60 is half into 1 by root 2, plus sin 60 is root 3 by 2 into 1 by root 2, so 1 by 2 root 2 plus root 3 by 2 root 2, the LCM here is 2 root 2, so 1 plus root 3 you will get here. So this is the answer for cos 15 degree. Now these formulae, you will get 6 formulae here in compound angles. You may be asked to derive them geometrically. These formulae can be derived, that is sin of A plus B, cos of A plus B, tan of A plus B, then sin of A minus B, cos of A minus B, and tan of A minus B. They can ask us to derive it. It can be derived geometrically. Now I will take up the derivation of sin of A plus B, cos of A plus B, and tan of A plus B. The other one I leave it to you to find, to do it. Now let us say we'll take this. There are three straight lines meeting at O. Now I will call this as OX, OY, OZ. These are three straight lines meeting at O. Let us say this angle is A and this angle is B. That is angle XOA is A, and angle YOZ is B. Then what happens is angle XOZ will be equal to A plus B. That is, this entire angle from here to here, this will be A plus B. Now we will derive the formulae for cos sin A plus B, cos A plus B, and tan A plus B. Now what I do, let me take a point anywhere here. I will take a point P on OZ. P is any point on OZ. Then from here I will drop a perpendicular. I will drop a perpendicular onto OX. Let me call this as M, this point as M. Okay. PM is perpendicular to OX, drawn from P. P is any point on OZ. Then what I do is I will draw a perpendicular. This is 90 degree. PQ is perpendicular to OY. PQ is perpendicular to OY. Then from point Q, I will draw a perpendicular to PM. I will call this as R, this point as R, where that intersects that. So QR is perpendicular to PM. Then this angle will be A, because this and that are alternate angles. These two are parallel to each other. This is a transversal. So this angle and this angle will be equal. And this angle will be 90 minus A, and therefore this angle will be A, because this is 90 degree. That is 90 degree. So PRQ is a right angle triangle there, where this is A, this angle is A. Now what I do is OPM is a right angle triangle. So sine of A plus B, you know, is sine is opposite by hypotenuse. So it will be PM by OP. that is opposite by hypotenuse. PM is opposite side, OP is the hypotenuse. Now PM can be written as RM plus RM plus PR divided by OP. I can write it like that. Then this is equal to RM by OP plus PR by OP. PR by OP. PR by OP. Now this what I do, RM, no, this I'll draw one more time. RM is nothing but QN. So QN by OP, QN by OP plus PR by OP. Now this what I do, QN by OQ into OQ by OP. What I have done here, I have multiplied and divided. I have multiplied both numerator and denominator by OQ. I have multiplied both numerator and denominator by OQ like this, plus PR by PQ into PQ by OP. See here, QN by OQ, QN by OQ, this is opposite side. OQN is also a right angle triangle. So QN is opposite side, OQ is the hypotenuse. So this will be equal to sine A. This will be equal to sine A. This will be sine A into OQ by OP. OQ is adjacent side in this triangle. This is a right angle triangle. OQ is the adjacent side. OP is the hypotenuse. So adjacent by hypotenuse, this will be cos B. This angle is B. So it will be cos B. Plus PR by PQ. This PQR is a right angle triangle in which this angle is A. So PR by PQ, that is adjacent by hypotenuse. So this will be cos A into PQ by OP. PQ is with reference to this angle, that is the opposite side, and this is the hypotenuse. So that will be sine B. So I got the relationship sine of A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. I have already used this relationship earlier. I showed you how to find sine of 105. I used this formula. This is how it can be derived. What I have done, I have taken three lines meeting at O. This is A, this I have taken as B. So this angle will be A plus B. Then I have taken a point P here, dropped a perpendicular onto OX. Then I drew a perpendicular, PQ is perpendicular to OY, and from Q I have drawn a perpendicular onto PM to meet it at R, and from Q I have dropped a perpendicular onto this. So this construction, and this is how it is to be done. I have proved sine of A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Sometimes they will ask us to derive this for 5 marks, this problem. They will say prove, geometrically prove that sine of A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Then you will have to prove it like this and you will get 5 marks for that. Next, similarly, we can prove cos of A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. Same figure. With the same figure, we can prove geometrically that cos of A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. Now, cos A plus B, cos is, you know, adjacent by hypotenuse. So adjacent this triangle you have to take POM is to be taken. So adjacent side will be OM. This is the adjacent side divided by OP. OM, this is OM adjacent side. OP is the hypotenuse. So OM by OP. Now OM can be written as ON minus MN. ON minus MN divided by OP. Now this MN is same as QR. So ON minus, instead of MN I can write it as QR by OP divided by this, also divided by OP. Again what I do, cos A plus B is equal to, this is equal to ON by OP. Now I will take it as ON by OQ into OQ divided by OP. Again what I have done, this is a ratio, ON by OP is a ratio. I have multiplied both the numerator and denominator by OQ. The value doesn't change. Minus QR by PQ. QR by PQ into PQ by OP. Again, I have multiplied both numerator and denominator by PQ so that they get cancelled and the value doesn't change. ON by OQ. ON is adjacent side. OQ is hypotenuse in this triangle. OQN. So this will be cos A into OQ by OP. OQ is adjacent side. OP is hypotenuse in the triangle OPQ. So it will be cos B minus QR. QR is opposite side. PQ is hypotenuse in that triangle. So this will be sin A into PQ by OP. PQ by OP is sin B, opposite by hypotenuse again in this triangle. So it will be sin B. So it is proved that cos of A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Geometrically we have proved it. Next we have to prove what is tan of A plus B. Tan of A plus B can be proved similarly. Tan of A plus B, it can be proved again from that figure, or it can also be proved, you know, tan is sin by cos. So tan of A plus B will be sin A plus B divided by cos of A plus B. So sin of A plus B is, we know, sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. This is the expansion of sin of A plus B. Cos of A plus B is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Now what we will do is, we will divide both the numerator and denominator by cos A cos B. So it will be sin A cos B upon cos A cos B plus cos A sin B upon cos A cos B, whole thing divided by, I have divided both of these by cos A cos B, here also cos A cos B divided by cos A cos B minus sin A sin B divided by cos A cos B. Now here this cos B gets cancelled, so what is left is sin A by cos A, that can be written as tan A, plus here cos A gets cancelled, sin B by cos B, that is tan B, divided by here everything gets cancelled, cos A, cos B gets cancelled, so the answer is 1 minus sin A by cos A is tan A into sin B by cos B is tan B, so tan of A plus B will be equal to tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. This is another formula. So now we have derived three formulae, that is I have derived these three formulae. First one is sin of A plus B is equal to sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. This is the first one. Second one is cos of A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Third one is tan of A plus B is equal to tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. Now similarly we can also prove, see this is here, say this is angle A and this is angle B, so this will be A minus B, or if this is B, this will be A minus B, so sin of A minus B, I think this is B, this should be taken as B and this will be A minus B. Sin of A minus B will be equal to sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. If it is plus here, it will be plus here. If it is minus here, it will be minus. Other things remain the same. Now, cos of A minus B will be equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. In this case, if you get plus here, you get minus here. If you get minus here, you will get plus here. Then, tan of A minus B will be equal to tan A minus tan B divided by 1 plus, this becomes minus and this becomes plus, other things remain as it is, tan A tan B. So these are the 6 formulae that we get in compound angles. Now from this we can also get the multiple angles. Multiple angles means, for example, suppose I want to know what is sine of 2A. Sine of 2A means it's a multiple angle, 2 into some angle twice. So then this I can write it as sin of A plus A. Sin 2A can be written as sin of A plus A. Then it becomes sin A cos A plus cos A sin A. Now these both are same, sin A cos A, sin A cos A. So sin 2A becomes 2 sin A cos A. This can be added, they are like terms, So 2 sin A cos A. This is also sin A cos A. That is also sin A cos A. Whether you write cos A sin A or sin A cos A, it is the same. So sin A cos A plus sin A cos A, that will be 2 sin A, 2 times sin A cos A. So sin 2A can be always taken as 2 sin A cos A. Similarly, cos 2A will be equal to cos A cos A, that is cos A cos B. You know, sin of A plus B is cos A cos B. Here A is also A, B is also A. So cos A cos A minus sin A sin B, sin A sin A. Instead of sin B, you get sin A only here. So cos 2A will be equal to cos square A minus sin square A. Minus sin square A. So you will get like that. This is sin 2A will be this. Cos 2A will be this. If you want tan 2A, tan of 2A will be equal to tan A plus tan B. Instead of tan B, again you get tan A only, because A and B are same. So tan 2A will be tan A plus tan A, 1 minus tan A into tan A. So this becomes tan 2A will be equal to 2 tan A divided by 1 minus tan square A it becomes. So this is multiple angles. Then sin 3A cos 3A, like that also we can find out. So this formula you will have to remember to do the problems on compound angles. Problems on compound angles. Now we will take up some problems on compound angles.